Can you please help me better understand the idea of free will? This is a common question. If Hashem created us and he knows what we're going to do before we do it, it seems kind of a rigged system.
Well, this question is brought up by the Rambam, the how could it be Bechira and Yediyah in Hebrew. Free choice and God knows the future. How is that possible? Free choice and God knows the future. If he knows the future, then we have free choice. Free choice, I mean, the person himself doesn't know what he's going to do. I can do that, I can do that. So how could God know the future if we didn't have free choice? So the Rambam brings up the question. And the Rambam tells us, doesn't really give an answer. He says that we can't understand God's ways. And even though we can't understand, doesn't mean that's not true because we don't understand it. I always give an answer, an example. If you give an ant and try to teach an ant 2 and 2 is 4, he doesn't know what you're talking about. His brain is not enough to accept it, because an animal, the brain only goes so far. You try to explain something to an animal, they can't understand you. They have a brain, they understand certain things, and they know when it's wet and when it's cold and when it's hot and to run, and they have brains. And they instincts that their brain communicates to them, but you can't teach them things that human beings know. So we cannot understand things that God understands, certain things that are above our intellect, and we just can't understand how it works. Try to speak about Einstein's theory of relativity, how to explain it. Who can understand that? I once was sitting next to somebody who claimed that I once mentioned it. He claimed he knows Einstein's theory of relativity. So I said to him, could you please just give me an idea of what it's about? So he started talking, I don't know what he's talking about. And when absolutely he started this and that, I don't know what he's talking about. I'd have to take many days, sit down, but certain things were above our intellect. So you have to be in that sphere of knowledge in order to understand certain things. And we're not in the sphere of God's knowledge, so can we understand how God can see everything at one time, the whole world, everybody's thinking and everybody's doing? It's something that's way above our intellect, because we're very small, our brain is very small, very limited, so we can't think the way God thinks. So this is something that, another thing that's not in the realm of our understanding. The Rabbi, Master, Rabbi, wrote the